Hi, and welcome to another episode of Paranormal You, the paranormal show where you, yes you, can be a part of. Brought to you by Relatively Haunted. And if you'd like to learn more about us, you can check out our website at www.relativelyhaunted.com. Or you can watch our show Relatively Haunted that airs Monday nights at 7 Eastern Time on FateRadio.com. That's www.fateradio.com. Now, once again, a quick rundown on how you can be a part of this show. You can either submit a question to the show in a comment form or a video form, or on Facebook and Twitter. And I'll try to answer your questions here on the show. Also, if you have any evidence that you've collected, whether it be an EVP, a photograph, or a video, you can send that to me and I'll try to review it on a future episode. Now, there's also a lot of great paranormal videos out there on the internet. If you find one that you think is particularly interesting, you can send that to me here and I'll review it on a show. And lastly, if you're part of a paranormal team and you have a hat or a t-shirt you'd like me to wear in an episode, you can contact me here on YouTube or Facebook and I'll give you the information on where you can send it to. Now, our first question I'm going to tackle in this episode is actually a continuation of an answer from last week's episode. And this comes from Nautilus, and this is what he asked. He brought up that in last week's episode I mentioned spirits being able to attach themselves to you, and he was wondering what the symptoms of that could be. Now that's a really great question, and I should have answered that in last week's episode, and because I felt it was so important I decided to answer it now. The symptoms can vary depending on the ghost that's attached to you. I'll actually use something that happened to my own mother. After an investigation of Waverly Hills, my mom started becoming quite ill. She started going to the doctors, but they couldn't find anything wrong with her. And at the same time, different members of the family witnessed seeing a little girl. Now, if you don't know a lot about the history of Waverly Hills, it used to be a TB hospital. Thousands of people died there. And we found out through further investigation that a little girl had attached herself to my mother, mostly because she missed her own mother. And the symptoms that my mom was having with her sickness were similar to TB. But after some time and some help, we actually got the little girl to cross over. And after that, my mom's illness went away. So what are the symptoms? It depends on the ghost that attaches itself to you. So I wish there was just one packaged neat answer to tell you, but unfortunately there isn't. Now our next question comes from Randy Davenport, and this is what he asked. He wants to know when we're going to start seeing ghosts from the 1970s with the wide collars, the bell bottoms, and the afros. This type of activity has already happened. It's just not something you really see on TV, because we've had cases dealing with ghosts that have died within the past decade. So I'll tell you what, Randy, as soon as I capture some evidence from a 1970s dude, I'll send it to you and let you know. Which brings me to the last question this week, which is on a similar theme. And this comes from Troy Schmidt, and this is what he asked. He wants to know if ghosts are energy, then how come we usually see them wearing clothing? Because clothing's not made out of energy, so why do we see them wearing clothes? One thing is everything is actually energy. Even a rock outside your door. So it kind of has different levels of being solid. Everything and everyone is made out of the same stuff when you get down to it. But that might not be the case of why we see them wearing clothing. In my experience, ghosts are somewhat on a psychic level. We've even had instances where we could think questions in our mind without saying them out loud and get the responses that we're looking for. So that must mean they can understand what we're thinking on some kind of a degree. So if they are something more than just energy, something more like psychic energy, then why couldn't they just be projecting that image? There's a lot of different theories, including that you're stuck wearing what you die in. Whatever the case may be, thank God that ghosts are wearing clothing. Because some of the ghosts we've investigated would be really scary if they didn't. Now, I want to share with you a video that I found that deals with the demonic. And it starts out like this. Wow, this sounds pretty epic. Oh my God, what could it be?
Dinky Winky,
Pinky Winky,
Dipsy, La La,
La La,
Ho.
Oh my God! Now that is demonic. But wait, it gets better.
Teletubbies,
Teletubbies,
say hello.
That's hilarious. Now that video wasn't paranormal, but I did find it quite amusing. And I did warn you, for those of you that watched episode 0, that the family does have a warped sense of humor. and we like to have fun, but we're totally serious about what we do. Now, the guy who made that video, Ty Tygon, is probably going to go to hell. And if you laughed, then he's probably not going alone. Now, he has a channel here on YouTube called Ty Tygon, the Maker of Horror. I'll put the link right here for you to go check him out. He makes a lot of really fun videos, and I suggest you go check him out. Because after all, YouTube's just about being you and having some fun with it. Now, this brings me to a completely new topic. It's not completely paranormal, but it does deal with the show. And that topic is trolls. Now, the show has definitely gotten its fair share of trolls, which I actually take as a compliment because that must mean I'm doing something right. Now, I usually just kick these guys out and block them from the channel, but I'm getting a little tired of that. So I've decided to leave our latest troll up for everyone to see. Now, his name is ConkersXBFD, but this is what I want you to do. No, I don't want you to go sending him nasty messages or harassing him. But this is what I would like you to do. You can go to his channel right here and you can do what I've done. Come here, give me a big hug. Because I feel this guy's real problem is he just needs a little love. So head on over to his channel, check out his videos, quick like, subscribe, leave comments, kisses and hugs and all that cutesy stuff. And maybe he'll wake up tomorrow just feeling a little better. You might be an asshole, but we still love you. Which brings us to the family question of the week. Now, to keep with the theme of showing the love, I'm going to let somebody else do the family question of the week. This video was sent to me by Mario vs. Sonic Girl, and I really liked her question and thought it would be really good for the family question of the week. So I've decided to let her ask this week's question.
Hi, it's Mario vs. Sonic Girl here with a question for Paranormal You. If you were a ghost, who would you haunt?
So you heard her. If you were a ghost, who would you haunt? Now remember, you can leave your answers to that question in the comment section below this video or on Facebook and Twitter. And we'll take the top 5 answers for that question and post it at the end of next week's episode. Now remember, if you enjoyed this show, please click like below this video, or if you'd like to receive updates about this show, you can click subscribe right above the video. Now it's time to show you the answers from last week's question. And that question is, if you were a ghost, what would you wear? Now I'm going to do things a little bit differently this week. We received a video response from EVP Investigations. So I'm going to go ahead and play that video before I post the comments. Just another way of showing you the love. So thank you for watching this episode of Paranormal You, and happy hunting.
Hi, Annie Kurosumi here from EVP Investigations, also known as Ohio Ghost Hunters in Avon, Ohio. You asked the question, what would you wear if you were a spirit? Here's the answer, I believe. You can't take it with you.
Great job on the video responses this episode, guys. Keep them coming. Because we've seen ghosts on certain cases that seem to be even from the last, and we've got an orb.